This is Clint Walker for Anglers Mail TV, and today I'm at Whiston Hall Fisheries in Staffordshire. I'm currently standing on the banks of the Bottom Lake, which is one of three small waters at Whiston Hall. It's probably an acre and a half in size, with only six pegs. So there are only five anglers allowed at any one time, just to ensure that there's room for all. The main target species is carp, which run to about 22, 23 pounds. They're all in pristine condition, they're immaculate fish. The centre island in front of us is an obvious feature to fish to, and as I'm filming I can see that there are carp moving around it. And just to the right, there's a spit of land that juts out into the water. You can't fish from there. That area is left as sanctuary for the carp to give them a bit of rest if things do get busy. You can see in the distance the car park. There's plenty of car park in there. And it's an easy walk down to the water. At the moment the bankside vegetation is well established, but the pegs are easy to get into. They're well cut. You've got plenty of room. And it's just a lovely little water. I've just had a word with the bailiff, John, and he tells me that because the water's quite clear, slack lines are a good tactic, and a good quality boilie is an essential. He's actually recommended a local supplier called Scott Air of SAE Baits Developments. That's the bait that goes into the water most often. It's well worth trying. Any good quality boilie will score though. So that's the Bottom Lake. We'll pause there and we'll go for a look at the other two lakes. So we've moved to the top of Whiston Hall Fisheries. And this is the second pond. Again, it's very well established. And it holds carp to about 16 pounds. There's a few perch and roach as well, but it is predominantly carp. Then you move to the central causeway. And the tackle that you can see in front of you is the bailiffs. When he sneaks an hour between his jobs. And then the third pool is a very shallow pool, about 3 feet deep, that's predominantly used as a stock pond. I've been led to believe that this place was originally dug out in 1979. It was used as a trout fishery and is now a carp fishery. It is quite a small place, it's lovely and secluded, but if you do want to fish it, it's very much advisable to book on by telephone before you arrive. There is a bailiff on site at all times to meet you and look after you. Sensible rules apply at the fishery, all your particles must be properly prepared. And the only real outstanding rule is that micro-barbed hooks must be used. So that's Whiston Hall Fisheries. If you want to find out more about this and many more like it, make sure you buy Angler's Mail every week.